In this video, I'll be ensuring that automatic archive creation is enabled on my PI Data Archive 2015 R2. It's important to have automatic archive creation turned on because over time, as our archive files fill up, new files are needed to hold new incoming data. Here in PI System Management Tools, under Operation Archives, my top entry is my primary archive, and we can see that it is 40% full. Once this primary archive fills up, the PI Data Archive will either look for a blank or old archive file to write to, or temporarily reject new data until it has an archive file with enough space. PI administrators used to have to monitor their primary archives to predict when archives would fill up to make sure that there are empty shiftable archive files ready to become the new primary archive. As of PI Data Archive 3.4.375, the PI Data Archive is able to detect when the primary archive is close to filling up, and if properly configured, it can automatically create a new primary archive to accommodate an archive shift. If you're not sure if your PI Data Archive is late enough to support automatic archive creation, down here in the version window, you can see the versions of your PI Data Archive subsystems. Here, mine are all well above 3.4.375. Now that we're sure of the PI Data Archive's version, the best way to make sure automatic archive creation is turned on is under Operation Tuning Parameters, then in the Archive tab. Here, the tuning parameter Archive Auto Archive File Route acts as a switch for automatic archive creation. Having a zero or a blank in this value will disable automatic archive creation, but having a file path followed by the prefix of a file name will enable it. Because there's a file path here and the start of a file name, automatic archive creation is already turned on. And if we navigate to our C PI Arc folder, we can see that automatic archive creation has already been creating our files for us. There is an important change, however, and that is that my archives have been automatically created on my C drive. Because the PI archive files are read and written to a lot, putting the operating system and archive files on different hard drives is important to maximize the performance of our disk's read and write operations. As we can see, I do have a designated D drive for my archive files. So back in System Management Tools, I can change my Auto Archive File Route to point to the D drive instead. Because these are automatic archive creation parameters, this change won't actually take effect until the next time an archive is automatically generated. Auto Archive File Format and Auto Archive File Extension will influence the name of your automatically created archives. Auto Archive File Format will let us choose between one of the three timestamp formats down here in its description pane. An automatic archive file extension will append that file format with an extension. Given my current combination of auto archive file route, file format, and file extension, if an archive was automatically generated right now, it would be in the D drive under PI Arc, and it would be named LRN PI SRV underscore year dash month dash day underscore hour dash minute dash second dot arc. When new archive files are auto-created, the tuning parameter auto archive file size determines their fixed size. The default is 0, which is outlined in the description at the bottom, will cause any automatically created archives to reflect the size of the current primary archive. We set the default in this way so that if you change the size of your primary archive manually, all subsequent automatically created archives will continue to reflect the new size without having to remember to change this parameter. If you do intend to change the size of new archives, I'll recommend that you instead follow the procedures in our live library to manually create a new archive, and use the archive size guidelines here also in our live library. Back in PI System Management Tools, our primary archive is still pretty far from filling up, and it's still on the C drive because, like I said earlier, none of our automatic archive creation tuning parameters will take effect unless an archive is automatically created. Rather than waiting for this archive file to fill up and have the PI Data Archive create a new archive file on the drive automatically, we can right-click to force an archive shift right now to test our automatic archive creation. During this shift, the PI Data Archive will give my previous archive file an end time, and create a new primary archive file with an end time of current time, and with the specified root path on the D drive. If I manually navigate to this folder, we can see that our archive file has automatically been created in this new PyArch folder on the D drive. So we can confirm that we are successfully automatically creating our new archives on the D drive separate from our operating system. This was a successful automatic archive creation and archive shift, but sometimes an automatic archive creation can fail. For instance, if the PI.archive tries to create a new archive file on a hard drive without enough space. When an archive auto-creation fails and there are no archives to shift to, as of PI.archive 3.4.380 service pack 1, the default behavior is for your PI.archive to hold event in the event queue until there is an archive with space available. However, in 3.4.380, the default behavior was to shift to and begin to overwrite your oldest archive file. The tuning parameter archive overwrite data on auto shift failure is responsible for controlling this behavior and is hidden in PI system management tools by default because we strongly believe that holding data in the event queue is preferable to overwriting your old archives. If you want to review this tuning parameter or to find other further reference material on automatic archive creation, visit the PI Server 2015 documentation in our live library and seek out the Manage Automatic Archive Creation section. In the next video, I'll be showing you how to move the rest of your archive files from the C drive to my new archive folder on the D drive where my new primary archive is. This move procedure I'll show you could also be used to decommission archives or to relocate them if you need to free up disk space.